Santa Monica on this gorgeous pier. We don't even know where we are. We're just
driving around.
Girls over here. Just driving around. Hey guys, hope you're doing well. This is Coach Corsi with California Philippines Bearcats. We finally made it to Siargao Island. A lot of work. This is a dream come true. Been wanting to come here for like 5 years now. And so we're in this beautiful paradise on the beach at Tao de Libertad. Just a beautiful location. And as I'm talking today, you might hear some motorcycles go by. Apologize for that. But I wanted to do another vlog on John Wooden. And now we're in the portion which I'm very excited about is when he creates the pyramid success. So really the title of this is what is success? So to John Wooden, success when he was younger was fame, was fortune, and was getting an A in his teacher's class that asked him to do an essay on what is success? Fame, fortune, and power. But as he got older and became a teacher, he realized that parents were putting a tremendous amount of pressure on their kids to get A's and B's. Wow, nothing's changed. This is in 1932. Nothing's changed today, it's the same. Parents are putting way too much pressure on their kids to get an A and B. So he created the pyramid of success so that we could all know that if you don't have fame or fortune, if you know, in a society it's always taught, it's number one or nothing. He wanted people to know that you can have success even if you're not number one every time. And that's why he created the pyramid of success. And it was really to help people understand, like when they lost, Martinsville lost in the state championship, he didn't consider that not successful. He considered that a success. They prepared, they worked hard. They just lost to a better team. When he lost at Indiana State, the Sycamores, when they made it to the final of the NAIB in 1948 and lost to Louisville by 22 points, 92-70, he didn't consider that a failure. He considered that a success just to get there and to have the opportunity preparing his boys. He knew they did the best they could do. So he really wrote this, and it's interesting, he wrote this, so let me get make sure I get this right, 48, 52, 72 years ago, he wrote The Pyramid of Success. And his coach Curtis had, in one of his coaches had also done something very similar, but he'd used a ladder to show the achievements as they went up. And so he didn't want to use a ladder and be like his coach. So he thought, hey, a pyramid would be a great way to explain it. And so he developed this, and by 1948, he launched it. He launched the Pyramid of Success. And I want to read this to you guys. I think it's important to read this one thing to you, is what he defines success as in his mind. And I want to read it so I get it right. And so I want to put my head down and read this. And it says, success is a peace of mind, which is the direct result of self-satisfaction, of knowing you did your best to become the best that you are capable of becoming. So it's a little confusing, so I want to read it again because there's a lot in here. Success is peace of mind, which is the direct result of self-satisfaction, in knowing that you did your best to become the best that you are capable of becoming. And a good example of this is that every athlete is built with different athletic abilities. When I played in college, I was slow, couldn't jump. You know, I had very little athletic ability. And I passed on what little I had to my son. I wasn't a dunker. I could dunk, but I wasn't a high flying guy. I wasn't extremely quick. I made myself into the best athlete that I could become. And I played college and I played overseas. But a good example of this is a good friend of mine, which remained nameless, 6'3", 42-inch vertical jump, had a massive amount of athletic ability, but he never used it. He could have played in the NBA if he really focused in on basketball, but he never used the talent he had. And thus he had a good career, but not a great career. He could have been an All-American. He could have played in the NBA, but he never applied the work ethic to his athletic ability. He never worked on becoming the best he could be, capable of becoming. And that's the difference between success and not success. If, you know, I always said that my college coach got out of me every ounce of ability that I possessed. He got out of me. He got it all out. And that is the trait of a great coach. And that is a trait of a great player, that you used all the things, the God-given abilities that you have in athletics or in business or in life or in your relationship, that you work hard at it and you become the best person that you're capable of becoming. And sorry, I'm sweating right now. It is very hot today, very humid. Right behind me is the ocean. I'm gonna put on this video a few scenery shots of Siargao Island so you can see it. But I want to explain to you is that the pyramid of success today has so much validity as it did in 1948 when John Wooden launched it. And I want to encourage you guys to really look it up. Look up the pyramid of success. I'll try and put it on this video as well. Check out, Google it, pyramid of success. It's an amazing template to judge yourself as, are you following the principles to be, in your mind, successful? Not in the world's mind, not in the way that the world looks at success, but are you becoming successful according to the pyramid of success? And I think this thing is great. He said that it's 148 times at UCLA that they were on the losing end of the score. In fact, two of those times were in the final four. In the last seconds, they lost. But he never considered his teams to be unsuccessful. He considered them to be success because they prepared. They worked hard. They got every ounce of ability they had out of his players. So, success, how do you view it? How do you view it? I feel like I've had a successful life. But in the world's success, I would never play in the pros. I'm not someone of fame, but I feel I'm successful because I got everything out of myself for my career and my basketball career and my business career that I had and laid it all on the line. And you just got to decide, are you doing it as well? And if not, start doing it. It's called the luck is a word called W-O-R-K. You want to be lucky? Work. Get the work on your skill. Whether it's basketball or business, work at it every day. So I'm working on this YouTube skill. This is weird to me to be in front of a camera. But I'm trying to learn. I'm trying to get better. And whatever you're doing in life, get better. Work hard. Do your best. Be a good person. And then you will have at the end of your life and say, hey, I had a successful life. And I believe for my life that God's not done yet, because he promised me that my latter days would be greater than my former days. So he's got a lot more work to do. I have a lot more work to do. And really in this world, to impact lives. So God's with me on that. So God bless you guys. Hope you're doing great. Coming to you from Siargao Island in the Philippines. And yeah, you know what's coming. Go Bearcats! Hey guys, Coach Corsi here. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like, and thanks for being a part of this vision for the future to impact our youth and the next generation. God bless you and go Bearcats.